Aloha, got a few minutes? This reflection is from the Reverend Marche Greer. I acknowledge my sin to you and my iniquity I did not hide. And I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord, and you forgave the guilt of my sin. From Psalm 32:5. Her story. You're addicted to feeling guilty, she said. You are so used to living in the guilt that you find reasons to feel guilty for everything, even if you don't really feel guilty. That's where you find yourself most at home. I stared at my therapist in silence. Of course, I'd heard of alcohol, drug addiction, all kinds of other addictions, even money addictions. But addiction to guilt? Now, this was a new one. So what do I do then, I asked. Start living in reality, she said. If you stop feeling guilty for everything without a reason, you'll start feeling and seeing all those things happening around you and actually have a chance to be happy. And I just couldn't let it go. I never let anything go without an argument. But what if I actually feel guilty about all of these things? Then realize you can't change the past and forgive yourself and do better next time. But I still don't think you even feel guilty. You're just not used to taking care of yourself. The feeling of guilt will never go away. You know, that conversation I had was what would be called an Oprah aha moment, but what I call, even better yet, a God moment. For sometimes, living with dysfunction and self-doubt is a lot easier than choosing to live the redeemed life our Savior intended for us to live. Look at the mirror. Shed your shame. Commit to being the best you can anyway. Lay yourself bare before God and know that even your worst days, you are just enough. I acknowledge my sin to you, and my iniquity I did not hide. I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord, and you forgave my guilt. Selah, from Psalm 32:5. God bless you today. Aloha.